Hello, I'm Matt Guff from House.com, and I'm here at the Outdoor Retailer Snow Show with Alex Warburton from Yes Snowmores. Alex, how are you?
Good, very well, too.
Good, very. Alex is the global brand manager for Yes. He's walking us through some of the key pieces and stories for 2019. Behind us is the 420 and the 420 Powder Hull. These are extraordinary boards that get a lot of traction. Everyone is asking about this on our YouTube channel. What's the story with the 420 clutching boards?
So the 420 I designed 7 years ago, I believe it was.
Is it that long?
Yeah, we were kind of jumped on it early. I remember the first time we did it, a lot of the reps and distributors were like, I don't know about that thing,
sure.
Kind of thing, because it's so short and so wide. The very first one is actually 146.
Wow.
I think this is a 152 in my hand now.
Okay.
So we do a 45, which is a narrower scaled down one for women and smaller feet generally.
Yep.
And then we do a 48 and 52. The original one was a 146.
Okay.
I'm 6'1 and 190 pounds.
Sure.
And it would float me. So the ideas was coming off a lot of stuff drawn from like fish surfboards or Steve Lissett specifically and knee boards, just getting like an exaggerated width and chopping down the length of it.
Yep.
So it's basically all about surface area. So on the 152, if you measure the surface area of the P-TEX, you're kind of more in the range of a traditional 162.
So it has a lot of flow.
The flow, you're just kind of redistributing it and pulling it closer to your feet. As you, a lot of the powder stashes aren't, we don't all have the luxury of powder fields.
I know.
But all the stashes are in the trees, right? So
yep.
This gives you the maneuverability, super low swing weight,
yep.
Gets you in and out of the trees,
yep.
But the flotation is there. What we found is that you get an awful lot of stability from width that we've always associated with length.
Right.
So a dude my size, well, you know, it doesn't have the length this way. You do get an awful lot of speed stability. It can go surprisingly fast. You can point it surprisingly fast.
Great.
And the flotation's all about area. All
yep.
about area. The stance on this one is placed a little bit back from center, but not that drastically.
Okay.
It's only got a minimal amount of taper, maybe 10 to 12 millimeters, depending
sure.
on the length.
Yep.
And it's got a really exaggerated side cut. So like on the 52, I think it's about a 6 meter side cut. Something
super
you might,
small.
Yeah, super turny. So you kind of compensate with the width.
Yep.
A little slower getting onto the edge, but once you're on the edge, it rails. There's no taper, so it's on hard pack.
Right.
So the surprising thing is on this thing, like, can rail hard pack, no problem.
Yep. Yeah. And there's two versions. There's the regular 420, and there's the powder hull version.
Yeah.
What is the big difference between these?
So after making the 2020 powder hull, which we've already talked about today, it seemed obviously natural. It's like, what's going to happen when you take that flotation on the base contours and pull it into a shape we all dearly love?
Yeah.
So because the powder hull drawing air underneath this deep pronounced concave and causing lift, we're able to kind of narrow the waist up a little bit,
okay.
relatively speaking. I mean, they can still like a 27 centimeter wide
yeah,
waist.
Right.
And then the powder hull in the tail, once again, helping that tail drop so we didn't have to rely on tapers or some of the more traditional tools of free ride or powder board.
Yeah.
And because you're not pulling that taper in, once again, this thing just rails apart. There's not as much of a compromise as
sure.
most powder boards have to give you, or you have to make a good make on. So.
Yep. Ah, that's
yep.
incredible. And for any guy out there that has gigantic feet, like 16, 18, 20, the 420 is going to be an awesome board because it's a waist width. Like this one, the powder hull has a little bit more narrow of a waist width, but this one goes up to like 28.6.
28.6 is the waist width, and then plus the exaggerated side cut makes it even wider across
yeah.
the foot. And
yeah.
I mean, the freedom being able to lean over and never have to worry about dragging your heels.
Oh, that's
like,
the best.
Yeah.
It is
really
the best. On hard pack. And then
yeah.
when you're riding deep snow, it just floats like a dream anyway.
Oh yeah, Pillow Lines is just like...
We gotta go find those. I don't know if it's in Colorado here right now.
We got some up in Whistler.
Do you?
Yeah.
Well, see you guys in the next video. We're going to Whistler. Alex, thanks so much for being here. Well, thank you guys for watching. Remember to leave a comment or a question and subscribe to the channel. We just passed 27,000 subscribers. We couldn't do that without you, so thanks so much. And hopefully, we'll see you on snow.